the end of your college career. Do you remember how it began? Here's some facts to jog your memory. Class of 2018 first year profile. 58% female. Shout out to those independent, educated women leading the world. We see you. 18% first generation, breaking barriers and living out your parents' dreams. We see you. 11% black. Congratulations, you 11% now have the honor. You have the honor of representing UNC alumni when Twitter starts another debate about PWIs versus HBCUs. Most common female name, Emily at 56, followed by Sarah, Hannah, and Caroline. Most common male name, John at 48, followed by William, Michael, Matthew, and Christopher. I know, we're all thinking the same thing about those names. But this is how you entered UNC in 2014, the same year that I left. It's important to remember where you began, because that is the only way you can track the growth. So now as you enter the corporate workforce, fulfill a two-year obligation with Teach for America, CCAT, relocate for master's degrees, or update your SoundCloud profile to verified artist, I want you to take a second and think of your progress. Are you ready for what's coming next? When I graduated, I wasn't. I didn't listen to the wise words of a real-life pit preacher, and that's when first failure entered my life. After graduating from UNC's dental hygiene program with a bachelor's of science, I was required to pass my dental hygiene boards in order to be licensed. The exam was an insanely meticulous hands-on procedure with a real patient. However, on my victory lap, I was more concerned with scrambling for credits, dropping a line for the baddest frat Chapel Hill, shooting my shot with all the crushes at bar golf, and all around senior year nonsense, and I'll use the term nonsense loosely. I ended my career at UNC exhausted, confused, and overly prideful. And it was those same things that led me to failing my boards. September 2014, entered a clinic in Greensboro at the crack of dawn with my uncle as a patient. Showed up without instruments or x-rays. Found out I'd need both before my exam started. Scrambled around this unfamiliar office for solutions while trying to hide the tears in my eyes from classmates and strangers whose faces have been burned into my memories. The exam instructors terminated my test before I even had a chance to sit my patient down. Failure. Tip number two, failure is the foundation of dreams. In today's society, we put a negative connotation on failure. When something fails, we automatically feel regret, remorse, and a bunch of other R words that probably just mean really sad. But what if I told you failure can be the source of fuel for the passion burning inside each of you? However, this wasn't a lesson I was ready to learn as a recent graduate who only knew success. I turned away from dentistry, gave up on the idea of working as a hygienist or retaking the exam. It was at least $1,000. I found myself lost at my post-bac program at UNC Charlotte, excelling in courses but wrapped up in nonsense. Again, I used the term loosely. I was masking the pain by making my resume pop. Became isolated after a while. It's something a lot of you might have experienced. Anxieties about the future, about the adult world starting to take over, all because I didn't know what to do after failing. So I set my sights on another goal. Dentistry. And yes, there's a difference between a hygienist and a dentist. We are the much nicer ones. The adult world is full of failures. Your failure will be different than mine. You may move to a new city and have no luck finding a job because you lack the experience. But the only way to get experience is by having a job. You may already have a job, but hate it after 3 months because the manager has no shame calling you at 6 on Saturday morning asking if you can work a 7-hour shift that day. You may lose out on promotions to lesser qualified people like Emily, who BuzzFeeds about her boy troubles, or John, who does exactly what a John would do. These factors can add to the pressure applied from being new to the adult world. Tip number 3, your day job will stress you out. Invest in something other than your career. Before I applied to dental school in 2015, I booked an appointment with my therapist. Tip number 4, I advise all of you to have the number of at least one therapist. Even when I was a student at UNC, I was occasionally in therapy, so don't write it off. Therapy is the reason I'm standing here today. Ooh. During my first visit, my new therapist asked me about my hobbies. I told him I'm into photography, but I hadn't done a shoot yet. He said, go to my hobbies whenever I'm hurting. Tip number 5, hobbies are important for your mental health. all sane adults at least have one. It doesn't make sense to anybody else as long as it feels right to you and is legal and within social context. It can be a sport, reading or scrapbooking, knitting, volunteering at a community center. Spending hours retweeting fire memes and 17-page think pieces is not a hobby, I'm sorry. It needs to be something engaging, active rather than passive. For me, it was my camera and writing. And I'm thankful for my hobbies because they helped me through the hurt of my second failure. I was just dropping the ball out here, people. Tip number 6, have hope, but make sure your faith is stronger. Failure number 2 happened on December 4th, 2015, when I did not receive an acceptance into dental school. I watched others post their letters on social media, some people who I didn't even know were interested in dentistry, a couple of Johns and Emilys who got in because daddy slips the school a hefty donation. It hurt a lot. Failures are going to hurt because we put hope into something that didn't work out. A silver lining came in January. I was waitlisted at UNC and ECU. Again, you can have your hope, but make sure your faith is stronger. As my name remained on that waitlist, I watched my dreams diminish. Some of you will share in my hurt. You will watch dreams die. Sometimes in an instant, other times over the course of a semester, I don't wish to scare you. I'm only preparing you for what could possibly happen. I returned to the admission officers at UNC and ECU, and they told me to pursue a master's degree after I just completed 2 years of dental hygiene and a 2-year post-bac where I excelled academically. I decided enough was enough. Okay, I decided enough was enough after I looked at the cost of these health science programs, but I also decided because I was not ready to sacrifice 2 more years to just a possibility. Tip number 7. Time is more valuable than currency to adults. Just don't try and pay Sally Mae in moments. Tip number 8. When a dream dies, you have 2 options. Attempt a revival, plan A. Birth a new belief, plan B. Neither is easy, nor is there a correct choice. But most will seek out plan A because it is what they've always longed for. It is that one thing they've wished of doing since those diaper days. I respect that. It's comforting to chase the same thing, but comfort can easily turn into complacency. Today, I'm here to advocate for your plan B. I spent my last few months in Charlotte formulating a new plan, which was to be a part-time hygienist and an artist. But this required me to face my failures again, something that I wasn't sure if I was ready to do yet. So I hit up my therapist. On my last visit, I asked him how I was doing. I told him I was denied from dental school, but the decision was oddly refreshing, and that I launched a photography blog and how the camera helped me with my anxiety. My therapist was this hippie guy who rocked an Egyptian-style earring, and I just remember watching that gold accessory glisten as he proudly nodded. The validation was refreshing, but the real joy from this final meeting was learning that my hobby helped me steer clear from that same nonsense that I experienced after my first failure. It only took me 2 years, but I finally listened to that pit preacher. Tip number 9. Come back home. It's dope to go out and establish your independence for a while, but consider coming back. Your parents probably want you there at least once more, even if it is to just help with chores. I'm still with my folks now, living rent-free. Tip number 10, rent, car payments, student loans, and insurance will add up quick. Make sure your savings are adding up faster. You're gonna want some extra funds so you can stunt with the rest of Passport and Brunch Twitter. I came back after spending 2 years on my own, 2 years after graduating. While you were transitioning to juniors, I was trying to make something of my life, still stunting it as if I had it all together. Tip number 11, imposter syndrome is the basis of adulting. We all fake it till we make it. While in the countryside of Fuquay, I recovered. I recharged, relaxed, re-energized, and any other R word that means got my life together. The back-to-back failures weighed heavily on me. But I was determined to have faith and to work at that. Tip number 12, growth comes through change. Change often comes in deletion before addition. I advise all of you to take a decompression break during these transition years, a time where you can unpack and unplug. There may be behaviors with bottles that need to be addressed, health and diet patterns needing correcting, reconciling with regrets, letting go of grudges and relationships beyond expiration date. You have to clear out space before adding anything new to the equation, because adulting will do its best to add stress to your life. Tip number 13, take a 3-month social media hiatus. It may seem like a long time, but so is changing. As I mentioned earlier, time is currency, so don't just get off the grid and waste those hours. Be active about your next actions, and do better. For me, that meant working on photography, writing poems and jotting story ideas, studying for boards, picking up soccer to balance out the sedentary life, and eliminating certain foods. No more 2 a.m. cookout burgers. During the time I left Charlotte and pursued my license, I worked at a community center and reconnected with my home. I also cranked out hours of studying every morning, saved up for the expenses, attended a 2-day refresher program in Connecticut. I hadn't had a patient in years. Contacted the testing agency multiple times to solidify date and location. Each action was another stepping stone leading me to my next challenge. 2 years ago, I didn't do any of that. But discipline is what helped me travel the distance. Tip number 14, discipline will drive you to your dream. Tip number 15, travel. Let wanderlust take you wherever it wants to go. After recentering, I prepared to face my failure again. Again, this is 2 years after walking out of that clinic with tears in my eyes. March 2017, I flew to New Jersey where I'd be taking my boards again. I explored my city with the camera on Friday, got scrubbed up for an exam on Saturday. This time I came prepared, visited the clinic early to know where it was, secured everything for my patient, and even rented instruments from the school. I came also carrying everything that I experienced for those last 2 years, those terrible twos. You'll probably all have some terrible twos. Get ready for them. The exam was tough. Patience steadied my hand until I was one of the last examinees left. But when I finished, I walked my patient out, retrieved my hiking backpack, and left with a business card for a travel dental hygiene program that offers free rent. Again, free rent is such a blessing. This morning, I had an interview with that same agency and they offered me the position. This goes to show, if I never would have taken that L in 2014, chances are my next opportunity would have never happened. There's good in failure. You just have to look for it. I found out I passed the exam after the transit pulled into the World Trade Center station. I treated myself to a weekend in New York. Tip number 16, treat yourself. Whenever you accomplish a personal goal, have a reward waiting. There are plenty of opposing forces in this adult world, so it's nice to have something to look forward to when you reach the end. Tip number 17, opportunity is not free. It will cost complacency. Nobody will hand you anything in this world. John might hand you a stack of documents to fax before lunch, though. You have to change if you wish to create an opportunity. The rewards of risking it are success and failure. Everybody aims for success. It's coveted by us millennials. Success is that one teacher who holds 3 exams and determines your entire grade, whereas failure is the professor who hits you with pop quizzes and mastering chemistry questions every Thursday. But failure is a teacher who will test your growth daily. It's because of failure that I'm now a cross-county traveling dental hygienist, a photographer with artwork displayed in galleries, the 46th ranked slam poet in the nation, a local soccer star, and it's failure that brought me to this podium today. Only 4 years ago, I was in your seat, wearing that Carolina blue cloth. I saw it in my closet this morning when I was pulling out my outfits. I was also thinking about shooting my shots before we all walked away in Keenan Stadium. It took me 4 years to learn what exactly that pit preacher meant when he ministered to me on that sunny day in the pit. Tip number 18. How you end one season is how you begin the next. When I started my artistry journey, around the same time I was denied from dental school, I read Meditations by Marcus Aurelius. This past month, I revisited the work. The book, which is a great read, is the BCE equivalent of everything that I've given you today. Like a guide to Romany, or maybe Roman, I don't know. Anyways, I want to read a few that stuck out to me the most. Don't be anxious. Concentrate on what you have to do. Nature thrives on forward progress. You have to assemble your life action by action. If you can succeed in trying, then you have succeeded. Every nature finds fulfillment in pursuing the right path. Regret is what we feel for failing to take advantage of an opportunity. Your days are numbered. Use them to throw open the window to your soul. Your time limit starts now. The rest of your life begins after this weekend. So enjoy it. Enjoy this beautiful campus, this little slice of southern heaven, because on Sunday you'll be draped in that same blue as the sky above, sharing smiles and tears as tassels turn. Graduation is the chapter's end. Then, what words are waiting to be written in this next chapter called adulting? As I close, I want to leave you with a homework assignment. I know, right? Homework, what? Buy a notebook. Any kind will do. They go for as cheap as $1.06. I bought them before. No excuse not to have one. Write in it. Write whatever you want, you think, feel, need to get off your chest. Plot your next moves. Imagine and create. It's the playground to your park. My first notebook was a flimsy 100-page moleskin that I barely managed to finish. Last week, I completed my sixth, a 256-page novel that is tatted up with stuff from an entire calendar year. Whenever I begin a new notebook, I dedicate the starting page to my future self. Upon reaching the end, I write a letter to my past self, the person who I was at the beginning of the story. This process marks completion, marks growth, marks the acceptance of everything that has transpired from that starting point until now. It's cheesy, but it's a way to interact and challenge yourself to complete that next chapter. Sometimes chapters can last a few pages, sometimes an entire semester, some chapters can take 4 years. But if you keep turning the pages, the end will come. To end is also to begin. Beginning is another way to just keep working. You keep working, your faith will strengthen. And with strong faith, you can face future successes and failures with hope. Thank you.